think of that weather, baby?
Don't like it.
Don't like it? Oh, it's just a nice summer rainstorm. It does look kind of creepy, though. I think I'm gonna go back to the cockpit. Yeah. All right, lead the way, baby. Oh boy, we are in the ICW in Florida once again. Thunderstorm season. Survived the thunderstorms and have made it to Titusville. We're anchored just south of that bridge, which I believe may be called the Addison Point Bridge. Not entirely sure, but we're tucked in here into this little narrow channel. There's shoals on that side and obviously a bridge on the other, because we're expecting a lot of rain to be coming from the northwest here in 2 days. And there's not many places north of here where you can anchor outside of current. Pretty much north of Titusville, you're getting into New Smyrna and Daytona, all the way up to St. Augustine, and there's just, all the anchorages are current anchorages. So with a bunch of wind coming in, you know, we try to set ourselves up as best we can, and things can get really weird when you have the wind blowing against the current. So we're just gonna sit tight here, let this blow through over the next couple days, and then we will continue on north. So we're still here in Titusville. I really haven't done a whole lot because the wind that was predicted to come in tomorrow, you know, pretty hard and heavy, it is here today. Or at least I really hope this is the wind and it's not going to get added on top of this. We definitely picked a good anchorage. We're here behind the Max Brewer Bridge. And the mooring field for the Titusville Marina is just on the other side of this bridge. And those boats in the mooring field are getting rocked like crazy. But yeah, this is what it's like even hiding behind this bridge. So we're getting gusts up into the 30s. We got a really good set on the anchor. We're in about 10 feet of water and I've got 70 or 80 feet out. So we've got something like a 7-to-1 scope. And the snubber is working really hard. but we're not moving. That anchor is absolutely buried. And as long as it doesn't get worse than this, it really shouldn't be too dramatic. But yeah, it's funny how these forecasts can be off by 24 hours in this case. Actually more than 24, more like 36 hours. Yeah. Just on the other side of the bridge over there, you can see whitecaps like crazy. And over there beyond the protection of the bridge, you can see kind of where the line of really dense whitecap starts. But it's not too bad behind the protection of this, you know, land that's underneath the bridge here. Snubber is stretched straight out there. Working hard, just about lifting the chain out of the water right there. Yep. But it's getting the job done. This is easily the most wind we've been in this whole trip. So we've just been hanging out down here, let the wind blow through. The girls are getting ready to do some more cross stitching. That's Tammy's latest project, and I think Molly's about to get going on a new one, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Molly has a loose tooth. Three loose teeth. Let's see if we can see that thing. Hang on, let me get this. Wait. Okay. All right. Go ahead. Oh yeah. Yeah, look at it wiggle.
Makes a weird sound. It's like a squishing sound.
You want me to get the pliers, Molly, and just go ahead and get that over with? You sure?
I don't think it's ready.
I think that would be something that would be very entertaining for people to watch.
I've tried pulling it today. I don't think it's ready.
It's just not ready yet?
It was okay. Really hard.
Yeah, okay. Well, that's what pliers would help out with. You can get a really good grip on it. Just with a little bit of a twist and a yank, it'll pop right out.
Uh-uh.
Okay, all right. I just want to take a minute to describe this scene that you're seeing here. So, I guess maybe every three nights or so, and by the way, ignore the lines on the screen. It has to do with the LED lights in our cabin. But anyways, every three nights or so, we'll watch this thing on TV called Death in Paradise. That is a TV show that we've been watching. It's a British show, and it's sort of like a murder mystery thing, sort of like Clue. And while it sounds a little funny that we've been watching Death in Paradise while in paradise, it's actually a very good show. It's good for kids to watch, maybe, you know, maybe kids of maybe...
Molly's age.
Yeah, Molly's age or so. It is a murder mystery, but it's really light, you know what I mean? But anyways, just wanted to share. So this scene that you're seeing in here with me on this settee, Skippy in his little playpen box here, Molly on the little fold-out seat here in the floor, and then Tambi's spot is over there with the TV here. This is actually a pretty common scene aboard our boat about every three nights or so. Right, ladies?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Molly, what do you think of Death in Paradise?
I like it.
Yeah? Do you think other people would like it?
Yeah.
What do you like about it?
You try to have to solve the mystery with the guys, people,
yeah,
before they do.
It's almost like it's a bit interactive, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And you like it, right, Tambi?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well that's enough about Death in Paradise, right?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go.
Let's go just for the night. Nowhere is ever too far, baby, all we got is time. small town, run down. So let's run away from here. From the ghost to the coast, where everything is clear. Follow me from the past into the future. We don't need any bags or any bastards. Let's be in the present. I don't wanna sweat it. I just wanna start all over. Just wanna start all over. All over. We don't need the memories. Just need to wipe the slate clean. Go from chaos to the peace. I need to focus on me. A small town, run down. So let's run away from here. From the ghost to the coast, where everything is clear. Follow me from the past into the future. We don't need any bags or any bastards. Let's be in the present. I don't wanna sweat it. I just wanna start all over.
Pretty boring stuff, except that we just spotted this helicopter up here that is carrying something. I don't know if I've ever seen this before in a non-military application. Oh, it's an American flag. Check that out. Huh. Hey, that's pretty cool. America. We are actually making water right now. Right there, coming over the side, you see the output water. You can hear the generator running back there. And this is far and away the yuckiest, brownest water we've made water in. But it was time to do so. So we're making water. There goes the paddle wheel boat. I have heard that whoever captains that thing is a very mean dude, and he will run you over with that, so I'm not sure if that's true or not, but I have heard the same story from multiple different sources, so watch it around Daytona. You could very possibly get run over by a paddle boat. Hi there, folks. Ben here in real time coming at you, and it's just me today. The girls are not here, but I wanted to say thank you for watching the video, and I hope you enjoyed it. Now, I am here in my garage in Toccoa, Georgia, and I just want to show you a couple things that I have going on. Over there, you see our furler, at least the foils to the furler. The foils and the rest of the furler and all the parts here is actually getting a complete rebuild, so that'll be ready to go this next season. Right there you see all of the wires for our standing rigging, and then underneath this table here, there are all the turnbuckles and toggles and studs and eyes and all of that stuff. The standing rigging is all getting reassembled on the boat here in actually just a few days, real time. This is actually one of the main ones I'm working on right now. I'm not going to go into any detail at all other than showing you some of the random components and things that I have going on. But if you recognize any of this stuff, you may be able to deduce what I'm up to. But otherwise, probably going to be filming a video on, you know, all of these projects here coming up pretty darn soon. But again, I just wanted to say thank you so much for watching our videos. Thank you for enjoying our channel. If you're not already a subscriber, please click that button and become one. Also, feel free to support our channel on Patreon. Patrons are actually what makes our channel work. We could not make these videos without the support of our patrons. So if you enjoy our videos, please look into becoming a patron. Otherwise, just continue watching and click that like button. So I guess that's really all for now. I'm going to wrap this up and we will see you next time.